Hello, I'm Neil Shaw from the law firm of Shaw & Associates, and welcome to another edition of this week's blog summary. I'm really happy to be recording this video from outdoors, and as you can hear from the birds chirping, spring is finally upon us. So here we are outdoors, and maybe something that's crept into your mind is your spring cleaning and how you're going to approach that this year. Well, if I can take a minute of that spring cleaning concept and sort of impinge upon your mind a couple of spring cleaning tips that you might want to read about from our blog summary. One is review your taxes, your credit report, and your budget. How is it going to play out for the rest of 2015, and how has the first quarter of 2015 worked out for you? Taxes should be pretty fresh in your mind with April 15th just having either passed or just pending, depending on when you're watching this video. So that might be item number one in your spring cleaning. Review your estate planning. Make sure that your wills, your trusts, your estate plan is up to date. And then also revisit your retirement planning. Is your retirement planning still on goal, on target? If you haven't started any retirement planning, now might be a good time for you to start. And if you want to read more about that, please check out our blog post referring to our spring cleaning approach. Along those same lines, because April 15th, like I said, is either coming up or just passed in our corners, I have noticed that people are never as on top of their finances as right around tax time. I don't know if it's the act of actually gathering the 1099s or having the conversation with your accountant or maybe a period of reflection on the prior year. But with the income tax planning is an opportune time to approach your estate planning because you have a very specific idea of your assets, and it might be a good time to revisit your goals and how everything works out. So with the income tax planning right having either been done or pending right now, it's a good time for you to pick up your estate planning topic. And there's actually a blog piece that refers specifically to this from last week. Along the lines of your estate plan, if you were to become incapacitated, if you are disabled, if you're not able to handle your own affairs, who's going to do it for you? You've heard me speak in the past about powers of attorney and how important powers of attorney can be. Well, there's a blog piece that actually talks about what your power of attorney should accomplish for you. And beyond your power of attorney, what other sort of disability planning or incapacity planning should you be considering? There's many people who think that if you were to pass away with debts, those debts are basically no longer valid. Unfortunately, with most debts, that's not the case. When you pass away, whatever you owe becomes a debt of your estate, and your estate is then going to owe that money. What do we do about that? When somebody passes away, and unfortunately that is a significant part of our practice, is helping those who are guiding loved ones of those who have passed away, such as executors or administrators or trustees. What do we do with debts when somebody's actually passed away? So there is a blog piece on dealing with debts for those and how we can plan around that as well. And then finally, if you are a business owner, if you are a corporate executive, or if you have an ownership interest in businesses or investments, business investments, what about asset protection planning? Have you shielded yourself from the liabilities, from the creditors, from the predators, if you will, that could arise from your business? And there is a piece, an article from this past week that refers to those who are running businesses and what they should have by ways of a personalized asset protection plan. I hope you're finding these blog pieces helpful. If you want to see these blog pieces in real time and you haven't already, please go ahead and like our firm page on Facebook. By liking our firm page on Facebook, you'll actually get these in your news stream on a regular basis. Connect with one of our attorneys or all of our attorneys on LinkedIn, and in that way you'll see that when we submit these articles as posts, you'll actually get them in real time as they are posted as well. Again, I'm Neil Shaw from the law firm of Shaw & Associates. Thank you and have a fantastic day.